Good evening there, YouTubers. It's about 7 o'clock now. Me and my guest cameraman Dan, who's back with me, just going for another walk through some woods. And I thought I'd do another wild food episode for the UK. The time now is the 8th of May. Okay, so the plants that I'm showing you will be found in April as well. And we've got two right next to us here. In fact, three. Okay, so I'm going to point these out to you. But the main one I'm focusing on is this little plant down here, which is called wood sorrel. Okay, so the identifying features are three shamrocked leaves. If I just pull this out, and you'll notice them quite easily because they tend to be more vibrant, and as the name suggests, they're found in woods, and you can find them in both deciduous and coniferous woodland. They tend to prefer acidic soil as much as they do a more stable soil. And when the leaves are young, they tend to be folded up in a little hat shape. Okay, so sort of like that. So they'll be folded down a little bit. And again, later on, you'll get the flowers. And we'll notice here the flowers, very fine stem to the flower, very delicate. And if you look there, you'll see we've got five white, slightly veined petals. And as these flowers grow, they start to turn downwards. So that's how you know you've got wood sorrel. This is a great food for eating on the march, for putting with things. It's got quite a sharp, grapeish maybe taste, sort of like eating grape skins. Very, very good eating actually. But you should really put them with other things. You know, don't you know, fill your stomach with just these, because they do contain oxalates, which is like a salt which can be harmful in high quantities. So. But just a few plants on the go is great. They're very, very tasty, especially when they get a bit older. They tend to get a bit sharper, a bit more flavoursome as well. Perfect for adding to stuff. Our second plant is, of course, nettles. I'm sure a lot of people know you can eat nettles, make nettle soup, etc. And you're tending to go for, again, the younger leaves. I'm not going to start picking them and eating them. You do need to either boil them. You can take the stingers off if you sort of hold it over a fire until they start to wilt as well. And then the third plant we've got here is goose grass. And again, because of its sticky nature, I'd probably boil that. Wouldn't go eating that raw. So that's just three edible plants that you'll find in one area. But these are best. The wood sorrel, which is the plant that I want everybody to see. It's best between April and May. So that's another one for you to find. Good luck with that, folks. Take care. Okay, so I'm just showing you a typical patch of wood sorrel, how you're going to see it. You'll see all the very bright green plants. That's how you're going to recognise wood sorrel from afar. So let me just wander into it. There you go. And again, you'll see those little flowers curling down. So that's wood sorrel. That's what we are looking for.